So on this one here, this one's also about Trump. What did you read this article or see this video where, you know, the preachers are praying over him?
Yeah.
Lord, I pray that you will bring into his life a strong African-American who can stand with him and represent that community so that his voice will be heard even in a stronger way there. Lord, whatever it is you're going to do to bring around him the right people as he moves forward in this campaign, we ask you to give him direction and give him hope. And Lord, thank you for allowing us to be here for this special moment.
No man can be successful as President of the United States without your wisdom.
Yes, that's right.
And so we ask you today,
yes, yes,
to give this man your wisdom, boldly,
yes,
make sure,
yes,
and certain that he hears it.
Yes.
Manifest yourself to him.
Yes.
And we thank you and praise you for a bold man, a strong man, and an obedient man.
The only two nations that have ever been in a relationship with God are Israel and the United States of America. Father God, in Yeshua's name, if you bring this man into the Oval Office, I speak your blessing over him for the sake of your people. Yabarechecha Yahweh v'shmerecha. Father, if you exalt this man to the highest office in this land, Father, we pray for wisdom, that you would be glorified and that your glory would be seen in this country. In Jesus' name, amen.
Father, we just secure him right now by the blood of Jesus. We thank you that no weapon formed against him will be able to prosper. And any tongue that rises against him will be condemned according to the word of God. And even as we lay hands on him right now, let your hand be laid upon him. Let him have a greater encounter with you, a greater encounter with the Spirit of God. That according to Ephesians 1:17 and 18, the eyes of his understanding would be enlightened, that he may know what is the hope of the riches of the glory of the inheritance of the saints. That any veil would be removed and his eyes would be open to see the glory and the goodness of God all the days of his life. Let him live well. I secure him.
Yes.
I secure his children.
Yes.
I secure his calling and his mantle in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay, so on that video, you can see that there are pastors praying over him. Have you seen that video?
I've seen parts of the video. I've not watched the whole thing.
So you know how Pentecostal people are, and they're putting their hands on him and praying God's blessing on him. So then here's another excerpt. It says, in late September, Trump met with evangelical and Pentecostal leaders, including televangelist Kenneth and Gloria Copeland, Pastor David Jeremiah, broadcaster John Crouch, I think that's how you pronounce it, Paula White, Messianic Rabbi Kirk Schneider, Pastor Daryl Scott. According to the Christian Broadcasting Network, the meeting with about 40 pastors and the candidate lasted more than 2 hours and ended with a laying on of hands, a Pentecostal practice of physically touching a person being prayed for. CBN reported the prayers were for the Lord to give the GOP president frontrunner wisdom, stability, and knowledge necessary to pursue this endeavor. So what do you think of that?
Well, hopefully he will get some wisdom to pursue the endeavor and decide that it's not the endeavor he should be pursuing. But I don't know. I mean, I don't give much credence to that. I mean, you know, I'll pray with anybody, even someone who disagrees with me, simply because I'm going to pray that, especially for wisdom. I'm definitely going to pray for wisdom because I believe that if they get true wisdom, then they will act properly. So I have no problems with that. I don't know that it necessarily comes down to an endorsement for their candidate. I'd have to see that if they were saying, well, I think you should vote for Trump, which would be different.
You know, that's kind of interesting, though, how this Christian TV really got onto him. you know, I don't know if they've done that with Cruz or Huckabee or anybody else.
I think they did that with Bush. I think they've done that with different people in the past. I don't know. I think actually I remember something vaguely about someone doing it with Romney, interestingly enough. I don't think it was as many. I think it was a few pastors here or there. But then there were just as many pastors who were speaking against
him. What if you were just happened to be like, let's say, a guest on TBN that day and they're all doing this? Would you gather in there and pray with them on this?
Again, as I said, I'm happy to pray with anybody, you know, and I'll pray that they get true wisdom. So, yes, I don't think I would be opposed to it. I don't know that, but it's not an endorsement. In no sense would it be an endorsement, you know. I mean, I would go into into Saddam Hussein's thing and pray with him.
Well, yeah, but you wouldn't pray that Saddam Hussein would have wisdom, stability, and knowledge necessary to pursue his endeavor of being a ruler.
Yeah. You see, again, it's one of those things where you'd have to ask him individually, do you really endorse Trump for president? And I don't know that many of them would. Maybe they would. I mean, who am I to speak into them? But yeah. I would just say that the presence there and the prayer there does not necessarily mean endorsement. And if it does mean endorsement, I would be very surprised. I'm kind of...
Okay. Well, how about we go on to the next one?
Okay.